गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू इन हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 9 एशियन किंगडम्स ऑफ द साउथ। सी स्टूडेंट्स, प्रीवियस चैप्टर 8 दैट इज स्टेट्स आफ्टर द मौर्य एम्पायर, ऑन दैट वी हैव लर्न द सुंगा डायनेस्टी, इंडो ग्रीक किंग, कुशाना किंग्स, द गुप्ता डायनेस्टी, द वर्धन डायनेस्टी एंड पावर इन नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया। All we have discussed previous, that is chapter 8. See students, in this chapter 9, we are going to learn about that ancient kingdoms of the south. See students, 9.1, the Chera, Pandya and Chola dynasties. 9.2, the Satavahana dynasty. 9.3, the Vakataka dynasty. 9.4, the Chalukya dynasty. 9.5, the Pallava dynasty. 9.6, the Rashtrakut dynasty. See students, these dynasties are most important. And see that student, in starting you can see the India map. Which place this dynasty established, you can see in map properly. See students, South India from 1st century BCE to 8th century CE. See that Satavahana dynasty, Vakataka dynasty, Chalukya dynasty, Chera, Pandya, Chola dynasty, Pallava dynasty. See students, all these all are the ancient kingdoms of the South. See students, in your index, sign and symbol are shown for caves and temples. Can you see that? See the caves in Satavahana dynasty place, Ajanta and Ellora caves. And see the Pallava dynasty, Kanchi temples and Mahabalipuram temples. That means with the help of the index, you come to know about that which place caves are there and which place temples are there in your map. So see students, these all are the famous and important dynasties. That means ancient kingdoms of the South. See students, you can do this. I have marked with pencil. No need to read this. 9.1, the Chera, Pandya and Chola dynasties. See students, of the many dynasties in South India, three are mentioned in the literature of those times. See students, dynasty means what? Dynasty is a period of time during which a country is ruled by members of the same family. That means a line of hereditary rulers of a country. That means if father is a king, son also become the king. And of the many dynasties in South India, there are so many dynasties are there, but three are very important. Which are the students? That means the Chera, Pandya and Chola dynasty. That these three dynasties are mentioned in the literature. You know students, literature means what? That means written work. That mentioned here, and these are the Chera, Pandya and Chola dynasty. These dynasties were in power around the 4th century BCE or even before that. You know students, these three dynasties, which are they? That is the Chera, Pandya and Chola dynasty, were in power around the 4th century BCE or even before that. They find mention in the Ramayana and Mahabharata epics also. And you can see that they find mention in the Ramayana and Mahabharata epics. They have also been mentioned in the Sangam literature in Tamil. You know students, they have also been mentioned in the Sangam literature in Tamil language. You can find that place also. And in the inscriptions of the Maurya Emperor Ashoka. And also you can see that in the inscriptions of the Maurya Emperor Ashoka. इन द पेरिप्लस ऑफ द एरिथियन सी. यू नो स्टूडेंट्स, दैट मीन्स पेरिप्लस ऑफ द एरिथियन सी इज ए हैंड बुक ऑफ द रेड सी. इट वॉज रिटन समटाइम्स इन द फर्स्ट सेंचुरी सी ई एंड इट गिव्स इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट ट्रेड दैट वेंट ऑन अलोंग द इंडियन कोस्ट लाइन, द पर्शियन गल्फ एंड इजिप्ट. एंड मुजिरिस इज मेंशन एज एन इम्पोर्टेंट पोर्ट ऑन द कोस्ट ऑफ केरला. यू नो स्टूडेंट्स, मुजिरिस इज मेंशन एज एन इम्पोर्टेंट पोर्ट. पोर्ट मीन्स वॉट, विच प्लेस शिप्स आर अराइव एंड डिपार्चर. एंड दैट प्लेस, दैट मीन्स मुजिरिस इज मेंशन एज एन इम्पोर्टेंट पोर्ट ऑन द कोस्ट ऑफ केरला. दिस पोर्ट वॉज इन द चेर किंगडम and was a major centers for the export of spices, pearls, precious stones, etc. And you know students that this ports was in the Cher kingdom and was a major center. Why it is major center? Because from that place, that goods, that means it was exported of spices, but that means it was a major center for the export of spices, pearls, precious stones. You know students, precious stones means what? A valuable stone that is used in jewelry, or that stones used in making jewelry, that is very precious stones. All these are exported to Rome in Italy and to other countries of the West. That was exported. And the Pandya kingdom was a part of today's Tamil Nadu. And you know student, the Pandya kingdom was a part of today's Tamil Nadu. There was a great demand for their high quality pearls, and also that place also great demand of their high quality pearls. And the capital of this kingdom was Madurai. You know students, the capital of this kingdom was Madurai. The ancient kingdoms of the Cholas occupied the region of Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. And you know student that the ancient kingdoms of the Cholas occupied the region of Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. And this way, these three dynasties, means the Cher, Pandya and Chola, that are very important famous dynasties. 9.2, the Satavahana dynasty. As in the north, after the decline of the Maurya Empire, you know students, the Maurya Empire ruling in the north place. After that, that means when Maurya Empire was started to decline, the local kings in Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka also became independent. Who are the local kings are there in Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka also became independent. And they started to establish small kingdoms of their own. And one of these was the Satavahana dynasty. And you know students, one of these was the Satavahana dynasty. Pratishthan, or the present day Pathan in Maharashtra, was their capital. That means previous their name is Pratishthan, or the present day Pathan in Maharashtra was their capital. King Simukh was the founder of the Satavahana dynasty. You know students, King Simukh, that means who was the founder of the Satavahana dynasty? So your answer will be students, King Simukh was the founder of the Satavahana dynasty. The inscriptions in the Naneghat caves near Junar in Pune district bear the names of the important persons of this dynasty. That means which are the inscriptions are there in the Naneghat caves, that is near Junar in Pune district, bear the names of the important person of this dynasty. Some of the Satavahana kings were known to write their mother's name before their own. And you know students, some of the Satavahana kings, they are famous to write their mother's name first. That means फर्स्ट दे आर राइटिंग देयर मदर्स नेम आफ्टरवर्ड्स देयर नेम. एग्जाम्पल गौतमी पुत्र सत्कर्णी. दैट मीन्स सत्कर्णी मदर्स नेम इज गौतमी एंड पुत्र मीन्स सन एंड देयर ओन नेम इज सत्कर्णी. एंड दिस वे राइटिंग द एग्जाम्पल्स आर शोन हियर गौतमी पुत्र सत्कर्णी. अंडरस्टूड स्टूडेंट्स? दैट गौतमी दैट मीन्स गौतमी मदर ऑफ सत्कर्णी एंड सत्कर्णी राइटिंग देयर मदर्स नेम फर्स्ट. दैट मीन्स गौतमी पुत्र सत्कर्णी. And this way, some of the Satavahanas kings were known to write their mother's name before their own. Understood, students? That means they are writing first their mother's name, afterwards their name. Example, Gautami Putra Satkarni. Understood? Of the Satavahana kings, Gautami Putra Satkarni is particularly well known. You know, students? In the Satavahana kings, Gautami Putra Satkarni is very famous. A stone inscription in a cave at Nasik describes his deeds of valor. Means that place at Nasik place. A stone inscription in a cave at Nasik describes his great bravery. Means his deeds of valor. He had defeated the Shaka king Napana. That means student Gautamiputra Satkarni had defeated the Shaka king Napana. He is described as Tri Samudra Toya Pit Vahan. And he is described as Tri Samudra Toya Pit Vahan. Toya means water. You know, students, Toya means what? Water. The title means, that means Tri Samudra Toya Pit Vahan. Title means, ones whose horses have drunk the water of three seas. The three seas are the Arabian Sea, the Bay of Bengal and the Indian Ocean. That means the title means student one whose horses have drunk the water of three seas, and the three seas are the Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal and the Indian Ocean. During his reign means rule, the empire of the Satavahanas extended from the river Narmada in the north to the Tungabhadra river in the south. That means when he is ruling as a power, who? Gautamiputra Satkarni. He is very famous. He is very well known. And during his rule, the empire of the Satavahanas extended from the river Narmada in the north to the Tungabhadra river in the south. Do you know? See, students, it is cancelled. I have marked with pencil. No need to read this. Famous poetic work Gatha Saptasati in Maharashtri, a Prakrit language, was composed by the Satavahana king Hala. You know, students, that means who was composed the famous poetic work Gatha Saptasati in Maharashtri, a Prakrit language? So your answer will be Satavahana king Hala. This work provides information about the life of the people during the Satavahana period. And this work provides in student full information about the life, means how the peoples are there, how their lives are there during the Satavahana period. And this way, this work provides information about the life of the people during the Satavahana period. Indian trade increased greatly during the Satavahana period. You know, students, Indian trade increased very large scale during the Satavahana period. Paithan, Ter, Bokardan, Kolhapur were recognized as important centers of trade. You know, students, which were recognized as important centers of trade? Your answer will be Paithan, Ter, Bokardan and Kolhapur. During this period, many artistic objects were produced at this place. And also, students, many artistic objects were produced at this place. Indian goods were exported. You know, student, exported means what? Send goods to another country for sale, for selling purpose. Send goods to another country for sale. We can say the exported. And Indian goods were exported as far away as Rome. Some of the Satavahana coin carry That means some of the Satwana coin carry image of ships. See picture student, a Satwana coin with a ship image. In the coin, we can see the ship image are there. The cave sculpture at Ajanta, Nasik, Karla, Baje, Kaneri, Junar in Maharashtra were carved in during the Satwana period. You know, students, the cave sculpture in, that means at Ajanta, Nasik, Karla, Baje, Kaneri, Junar in Maharashtra were carved. Carved means what? To carve a statue out of stone during the Satwana period. See picture, the Chaitya Griha at Karla. Point 3, the Vakataka dynasty. The power of the Satwana began to weaken by the 3rd century CE. Among the dynasty that emerged after that, the Vakataka was a powerful dynasty. You know, students, the power of the Satwana began to weaken, means weak, by the 3rd century CE. Among the dynasty that emerged means appear after that, the Vakataka was a powerful dynasty. It was founded by the king Vindhya Shakti. And you know, students, Vakataka was a powerful dynasty. And the founder of the Vakataka dynasty, king name is Vindhya Shakti. That means Vindhya Shakti was the founder of the Vakataka dynasty. He was succeeded by Pravarsen first. And Vindhya Shakti was succeeded by Pravarsen first. After his death, the kingdoms of the Vakatakas got divided. That means after the death of Vindhya Shakti, the kingdom of the Vakatakas got divided. There were two main branches. How many branches, student? Two main branches. The capital of the first was at Nandivardhan near Nagpur. And the capital of the other branch was at Vatsagulam, which is today Vasim. And this way, two main branches divided into part. Two main branches are there. The capital of the first was at Nandivardhan near Nagpur, and the capital of the other branch was at Vatsagulam, which is today's Vasim. Pravarsen first, son of Vindhya Shakti, extended the Vakataka kingdom in the north up to Malwa and Gujarat, and in the south up to Kolhapur. That means Pravarsen first extended the Vakataka kingdom in the north up to Malwa and Gujarat, and in the south up to Kolhapur. At that time, Kolhapur was known as Kuntal. You know, students, at that time Kolhapur name was Kuntal. That means at that time Kolhapur was known as Kuntal. Have read that the Gupta emperor Chandragupta II had married his daughter Prabhavati to Rudrasen II. You know, students, that means we have already read that the Gupta emperor Chandragupta II, he had married his daughter Prabhavati to Rudrasen II, the Vakataka king. You know, that means Rudrasen II, the Vakataka king. Varadev, a minister of the Vakataka king Harisen. That means Varadev, a minister of the Vakataka king Harisen, was a follower of Buddhism. That means was a follower of Buddhism. Cave number 16 at Ajanta was dug at his instance. Some other caves at Ajanta were dug and beautified, means to make beautiful, with painting during Harisena's reign. That means reign means rule. The Vakataka king Pravarsen II composed, that means the Vakataka king Pravarsen II composed Setuband in Maharashtri, a Prakrit language. Similarly, Kalidasa's Meghdoot also belong to this period. You know, student, that means cave number 16 at Ajanta was dug at his instance, and some other caves at Ajanta were dug and beautified with painting during हरिसेनास रेन. दैट मीन्स वेन हरिसेनास वॉज रूलिंग एज अ पावर ऑल दैट टाइम. द वकटका किंग प्रवरसेन सेकेंड कंपोज सेतुबंध इन महाराष्ट्री ए प्रकृत लैंग्वेज. दैट मीन्स इन महाराष्ट्री ए प्रकृत लैंग्वेज. सिमिलरली कालिदासास मेघदूत ऑल्सो बिलोंग टू दिस पीरियड. सी स्टूडेंट पिक्चर ए केव एट अजंता. कैन यू सी दैट एंड सी द पिक्चर. बोधिसत्वा पद्मपाणी डेट इज अजंता प्लेस. सी दैट पिक्चर ऑफ दैट. कैन यू सी दैट. 9.4 द चालुक्य डायनेस्टी. द चालुक्य डायनेस्टी इन कर्नाटका वॉज ए पावरफुल वन. द किंगडम्स ऑफ कदम्बा कालाचुरी हैड बिकम पावरफुल आफ्टर द डिक्लाइन ऑफ द वकाटकास. बट द चालुक्य किंग एस्टैब्लिश देयर डोमिनेंस ओवर ऑल ऑफ देम. यू नो स्टूडेंट द चालुक्य डायनेस्टी इन कर्नाटका वॉज वेरी पावरफुल. द किंगडम्स ऑफ द कदम्बा कालाचुरी हैड बिकम पावरफुल आफ्टर द डिक्लाइन ऑफ द वकाटकास. एंड दिस किंगडम ऑल्सो बिकम पावरफुल आफ्टर डिक्लाइन ऑफ द वकाटकास. But the Chalukya kings established their dominance. Dominance means what? Supremacy power over all of them. Pulakesi first established the rule of the Chalukya dynasty in the 6th century. You know, student? Pulakesi first established the rule of the Chalukya dynasty in the 6th century CE. His capital was Badami, which was earlier called Vatapi. And his capital was Badami, which was earlier called Vatapi. The Chalukya king Pulakesi II had successfully repulsed Emperor Harshvardhan's invasion. You know, student, the Chalukya king Pulakesi II, he had successfully repulsed means what? Dry back or an attack by force. Emperor Harshvardhan's invasion. The famous temples at Badami, Aihole and Patadkal were built during the Chalukya period. And in a student, the famous temples at Badami, Aihole and Patadkal were built during the Chalukya period. See students, the temple at Patadkal. Can you see that? Now 9.5. The Pallava dynasty. The Pallava were also a powerful dynasty in South India. You know, student, the Pallava were also a powerful dynasty. In where? In South India. See picture that. The Ratha or chariot temples at Mahabalipuram. See the picture. Kanchipuram in Tamil Nadu was their capital. Mahendra Varman was an able Pallava ruler. You know, student, Kanchipuram in Tamil Nadu was their capital. And Mahendra Varman was an able Pallava ruler. He expanded the Pallava kingdom very large scale. He was also a playwright. His son Narasimha Varman repulse means what? Draw back or an attack by force. He repulsed the attack on his kingdom by the Chalukya king Pulakesi II. You know, student, who repulsed the attack on his kingdom by the Chalukya king Pulakesi II? See, student, Narasimha Varman. The famous Ratha temples of Mahabalipuram were sculpted. Sculpted means carved during his rule. These temples have been sculpted in single rocks. And you know, student, these temples have been sculpted in single rocks. The Pallavas had a powerful and well-equipped navy. And you know that, student, Pallavas had a very powerful and well-equipped navy. During this period, India came in close contact with the countries of Southeast Asia. And this way, during this period, India came in close contact with the countries of Southeast Asia. Internal and foreign trade flourished. Flourish means prosper. That means internal and foreign trade flourished with large scale. Yuan Chong had visited Kanchi and recorded that people of all religions received tolerant And this way, Yuan Chong, he had visited Kanchi. He is a traveler. He visited Kanchi and recorded that people of all religions receive tolerant and just treatment. Then all are getting the justice. There is no injustice under the rule of the Pallava king. 9.6 The Rajputa dynasty. See student, the Rajputa dynasty also very famous dynasty. At the height of their power, the dominion of the Rajputa dynasty extended from the Vindhya mountains up to Kanyakumari in the south. So see students, at the height of their power, the dominion of the Rajputa dynasty extended from the Vindhya mountains up to Kanyakumari. That means from the Vindhya mountains to Kanyakumari in the south. This dynasty extended. Their power was first established in Maharashtra by King Danti Durga. And you know, student, their power was first established in Maharashtra by King Danti Durga. Krishna Raja first had the famous Kailash temples carved at Ellora. And you know, student, Krishna Raja first had the famous Kailash temples carved at Ellora. And this way, Rajputa dynasty also very famous. And at the height of this their power, the dominion of the Rajputa dynasty extended from the Vindhya mountains up to Kanyakumari in the south. And their power was first established in Maharashtra by King Danti Durga. Krishna Raja first had the famous Kailash temples carved at Ellora. You should know about that, student. Krishna Raja first had the famous Kailash temples carved at Ellora. See students, up to now we have learned about the different dynasties that ruled ancient India. So in this topic, what we learned, that we have learned about the different dynasties that ruled ancient India. In the next lesson, we will revive the social and cultural life in ancient India. So see students, in the next lesson, we will revive the social and cultural life in ancient India. See students, the Kailash temples at Ellora, that is Werul place. Can you see that? Kailash temples at Ellora. Do you know? See students, do you know? Totally cancel. I have marked with pencil. No need to read this. Exercise. Question number 1. Can you tell? Question number 2. Complete the table by reading the map in the lesson. Question number 3. Tabulate the following names as dynasties and their capitals. Question number 4. Observe any three pictures in the lesson and write in your own words what you learn from them. Question number 5. Answer in one sentence. And question number 6. Answer in brief. See students, all these are the assignment I am giving to you as your homework. You have to do this in your notebook and read this lesson twice, two times properly. I hope that you understood this lesson. Thank you.